Nematodes are small parasitic roundworms. They are part of the animal kingdom and are important pests on plants worldwide. Nematodes normally attack the root system of plants. Symptoms produced by nematodes are often seen as areas of dead plants. These are normally found in patches that may follow drainage lines. This picture shows a rather large patch of dead plants that is in a low-lying area of the field. The soil in this area has enough nematodes that they have killed the plants. Nematodes are parasitic roundworms. They normally have an elongate shape. We differentiate them based on their mouth parts. Free-living nematodes feed on soil matter and have open mouth parts. This nematode is free-living and has open mouth parts. Plant parasitic nematodes have a stylet in an oral cavity, and this is used to pierce the plant tissue and remove sap from it. You can see it illustrated here in the end of the nematode. These are illustrations of stylets on plant parasitic nematodes, and you can see the format of the stylet. The bottom of the stylet is referred to as a basal bulb. This is attached to muscles that control the movement of the stylet. This picture is of a plant parasitic nematode where you can see the stylet. You can also see the basal bulb. This nematode has a different kind of stylet that does not have a basal bulb. This stylet is more elongate and is attached at the base to the esophagus, which leads to the digestive system below. These nematodes are from forest soil and they have skin that is not smooth. You can see the rings around the body. The entire nematode is visible, and you can see the overall form. This stylet is quite long, and the basal bulb is visible. One of the interesting things about nematodes is that they molt or change their skin occasionally. On this one, you can see that the skin has separated, and it is outside of the newly formed inner skin. This may continue to stay on the nematode for a time before it is released. This nematode has a short stylet that looks much like a dagger. These can easily penetrate into the root system of plants, and as they do, they create quite a wound. This nematode belongs to the genus Bolonolimus. It has an extremely long stylet and an interesting feeding habit. Rather than come into the side of the root, these nematodes will come to the root cap and then puncture the root down the center. This will cause damage to both the meristem as well as the quiescent center of the root. Root damage like this will not recover, so a pathogen like this will cause considerable damage to the root system. The number of nematodes in the soil of this genus that are required to cause damage are very low compared to the ones with the dagger-like stylets that do less damage to the roots in small numbers. This last nematode has a mouth cavity that feeds on bacteria and other organic matter in the soil. The rest of the nematode body is interested in two things, digestion and reproduction. Looking at this diagram, all you see is the digestive system and the reproductive system. In this photo, the arrow points to the anus, which is the other end of the digestive system, and is shown here on the drawing as well. These next two drawings show the spicules that are used to open the female genitalia. They are illustrated in the photograph. They are made of a hardened material. The opening in the female, which the eggs are laid, is indicated in this photo. These pictures also show the overall format of plant parasitic nematodes. This one is very long and whip-like, and the stylet is inserted into the plant tissue. This next one is a male, and the male organs can be easily seen here. This last one is on the inside of a root with a shorter stylet evident. This represents the overall morphology of plant parasitic nematodes. There are some variations that we will observe in the next part.